James here from Devoted Gaming, and this is a walkthrough for Destiny. Hey guys, welcome back to the walkthrough. Today we'll be covering the last Urn-related mission, which is to take the Urn to the moon for the Ritual of the Forsaken. Now I have a friend with me, I have Yoshi with me, because this mission is kind of difficult due to the ending part. But since I'm here with a friend, so I'm going to play level 30. Even though I'm 29, at least I can rely on my friend to help me.
Soon the Hive will sacrifice the Forsaken as a plea to Oryx. Deny them this offering. Find the Forsaken, and bring me the Eyes.
Make your way to the world's grave. Lure out the Forsaken. And don't forget, I need the Eyes.
So basically, we aren't going to anywhere new locations on the moon. We're actually going down to the Chamber of Night, where we did one of the moon main story missions. But this is going to be a little different once you get down there. Other than that, the path down to the Chamber of Night isn't any very different. Well, aside from the level 30 enemy, that is. Now, you don't have to like fight every enemy, you can just run past, but you know, that's still fun. Well, especially the part where Yoshi blew himself up with a rocket launcher because the rock got into his face, but that's his own fault. Here we are in the Chamber of Night. Now to activate this next part, you need to stand by the cauldron. Once you do, as you can see, all these green circular beacons will appear, and you all know that if you stand near them, they will detonate, dealing some damage to you. But of course, lots of sort of cruel dust will spawn also by the cauldron, and I do advise you use some of them. However, you know, the amount of enemies you face may be overwhelming, but there are cursed walls, so using your sword against them might not be the smartest idea due to the fact that if you destroy them, you receive a lot of damage because they explode. So we ended up dying because we're being very careless. Because the most annoying part about this is when you die, especially if you're holding a sword, if an ally tries to revive you, the problem is the same button to pick up a sword is the same button you use to revive each other. So your allies will tend to pick up the sword you dropped through death. So that's the annoying part. And due to the fact that me and Yoshi were goofing around, that's how we died. So usually, each group of enemies will consist of acolytes, knights, thralls, and cursed thralls. Near the very end, you encounter wizards, which are probably the most dangerous in this situation because aiming your sword to attack wizards is very difficult. And finally, you will know it's the final wave when you encounter ogres.
Forget. Bring me the eyes.
Alright, I'll meet you guys back at the tower where I will cure Eris of her weird obsession with eyes. Now, once you get back to the tower, you really can't end it yet because you have to take the eyes that you picked up on this quest to Xur, where he will turn them for Eris. So, I technically can't end. Do anything until this weekend. So, thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Bye.